your chips. Those come from your mystery meetings. You have two birthdays a year, and I think that's the coolest. You take me swimming every Friday, and always check the deep end to make sure there are no sharks coming to get me. I want to be just like you. 10. Dear Dad, happy 13th birthday. I really don't get that because you turned 37 last month, but Mom told me to go with it, so I guess I will. You got another chip today, and I think the two are related, but really, I'm not sure, and truly, I'm not sure of anything. And why is my sister still gone? You said she'd only be away for a month, and why does Mom call you the glue? And why do you leave every night when you think I'm asleep? I am not asleep. I know now that you cannot lift our whole house, even if you tried, but wasn't I cute when I thought that you could? I don't know how your chips and your mystery meetings are correlated. I learned that word last week, Dad, or why they're called chips at all, because they're metal. And frankly, they don't taste good, but I know they make you happy, so I am too, and I'm never gonna drink because neither do you, dear Dad. I still wanna be just like you. 15. Dear Dad, happy birthday. I'm writing to you from my second consecutive meeting. In one day, Lauren, Alyssa, and Charlie all want to be my sponsor, and I don't really know if I want one. If I cared about my 12 steps, I would invest in a Fitbit. Anyway, happy 18th birthday. I am a lot like you. 16, relapse. It shocks me as if I am not the one, eyes closed, lips pressed to the cold brim, taking it in like a long-lost love that was probably meant to stay lost. I am sitting in bed, and all I can think about is the last time this happened. The last time he gave me one more pearly white sandy matte pill with the indents on it that makes me tired and angry and dizzy, that dissolves in my mouth if I am unable to wash it down quickly enough. He gave it to me in an attempt to make me overdose. Dear girls, if they want to drown you, make sure it is in love, not booze. Make sure they are not instead suffocating you with pretty colors wrapped in a polymer barrier that make you tired and angry and dizzy, that dissolve in your mouth if you're unable to wash them down your throat quickly enough. Girls, if they want to make you overdose so that they can take care of you, run. And if you are unable to move your legs due to the poison that you have placed on your tongue and washed down your throat with flammable water that is now moving throughout your bloodstream, try to remove yourself from your body. Call your sponsor. Invest in that Fitbit 16, dear Dad. Happy 21st birthday. I'm sorry, I've had the numbers wrong this whole time. I'll try harder to remember. You deserve more credit. This is hard. I'm sorry I'm disappointing you and you are unaware of it. I think I'll call Lauren tomorrow. Maybe Alyssa or Charlie. Maybe not tomorrow.